Tuttle, who was it?
You're looking at the wrong recruit, sir.
So it was someone else, then? Not wise to point the finger at your new brothers, Tuttle. Gared Tuttle here wants to be a ranger, so we can go north of the wall and die on some wildling spear. But what he wants doesn't mean shit. So today you're all gonna show me what you're made of. Can you swing a sword? Shoot a bow? Are you strong? Those who do well might just survive. The rest of you.
Frostfinger. I need a word.
Go on, get started.
Best of luck, Tuttle.
Here we go. Again. Bows up.
See those dummies? Those are fens. Come to eat your brains for breakfast.
Not quite.
Castle Black. So this is home now. You're doing that all wrong.
But we don't have these where I...
Lance Raider will shit himself when he sees you coming.
Let me show you.
All right, let's see if you can aim worth a wildling's arse. Shoot the targets I tell you to. Let's start easy. Middle dummy, center of the chest. You can follow orders at least. Next bolt. Left target, head. Good. Right target, chest. Not bad. Center, between the eyes. One less wildling. You hit all of them. Nicely done.
Finn thinks he's so bloody clever. If a real wildling got his hands on him...
Ah, he's just a bully.
Aye, he is. That's why I took this. Swiped it right off him. Don't tell, all right? I don't think he'd take it kindly.
Give it back to him, Cotter.
Are you mad? That's the last thing I'll do.
Can't wander off now. Not a Frostfinger watching.
Stop gawking, Tuttle!
Take that! Take that, you whore!
Watch your bloody tongue!
You, grab a practice sword.
This one should do.
I'll be sparring with you today.
Are you hard of hearing?
Remember, these blades are dulled, but a sword's still a sword. Good luck. Come on, keep at it. Well fought.
Get off me, you bloody ox.
You got lucky.
You there, recruit. Scrawny, aren't you? See if you can carry one of these barrels over to the winch.
Right. I can do this.
Want some help?
Don't hurt yourself, Tuttle. I'm thinking steward for you. You can help Frostfinger wash his cock.
No.
If the thing hasn't frozen off. I'll be a ranger. Just you watch.
Not holding my breath, brother.
Not quite.
You're pathetic.
Fuck off. You didn't even try.
A crossbow's a coward's weapon. Besides, I could hit that dummy from here with my... Where is it? Where the fuck's my knife? If someone has it, I'll cut their fucking balls off.
Maybe someone stole it.
Who the fuck would have...
It was you.
What? You little fucking thief.
It weren't me.
Finn, don't. Give me my knife!
I don't have it, I swear.
Out of my way!
Gared, do something.
Let's stop it before someone...
I won't say it again.
Fuck!
Hey, look.
Fight!
Yeah, get him!
There they go again.
Get off!
What is going on here?
He stole my fucking knife!
No, I didn't.
And Gared defended him.
The last thief I caught no longer has hands.
I swear I don't have it.
You must have hid it.
And you. I expected better, Tuttle. Instead, I find you doing this on your first bloody day of training. You clearly need a few days scrubbing the latrines.
Frostfinger, I need another man atop the wall.
Fine. Let him freeze his balls off. I'll deal with this one.
Get off!
Mind your fucking manners.
You, come with me.
This way. I love King's Landing in the afternoon. The sun just barely kisses your skin. You used to love this place. Remember, we'd come listen to the musicians in the evening with Lady Marjorie?
I have a lot on my mind lately.
Just through here.
What are you doing?
You'll see. Queen Cersei's finest wine.
You're going to get us both in trouble.
Relax. Nobody will miss it, I assure you. A little won't hurt. Suit yourself, then. So, I'm not very good at this sort of thing. Listen, if I tell you this, Mira, you must promise to keep it to yourself. You can tell no one. I want to trust you.
I swear, I won't tell a soul.
My mother was a handmaiden to Lady Elena for many years. She became pregnant. It was a disgrace to her family. My true name is Sarah Flowers.
You're a bastard?
Yes. I'm fortunate to be where I am, I know that. But to always have to hide.
What happened to your mother?
Lady Elena asked no questions. She took care of my mother. And when I was born, she gave me the name Durwell. My mother died not long after.
Who else knows about this?
Lady Marjorie, her grandmother, and now you. It's just, I don't want to be Sarah Flowers forever. I need Lady Marjorie to arrange a marriage for me. It's my chance at a life.
Did you have someone in mind? Someone you'd wish to marry?
I'd have to convince Lady Marjorie to make an introduction first. I know she often confides in you, and I was hoping that maybe sometime when she comes to you wanting to talk, you might suggest she talk to me instead. Give me a chance to win her over. Coming from you, it's sure to mean a lot.
Of course, Sarah.
Thank you, Mira. Thank you. I'm so sorry. Here I am talking about myself. I know your family's troubles are much greater than mine. With what happened to your brother and your father. You sure you won't have any? You look like you could use a drink.
A conspiracy of handmaidens.
Lord Tyrion.
My lord.
Ladies? What have we here? If you mean to drink from that flagon, you're going about it the wrong way.
It's not what it looks like. We were just
airing the wine? Not the finest Arbor Red, but a favorite of my sister's. Quite expensive for a handmaiden. I'd be curious to know how you got hold of it. Since I'm certain my sister didn't give it to you, she won't even share with me.
We found it.
Found it? Where?
In that bush.
Lord Tyrion.
Strange it should find its way into a bush. If Cersei knew you had this wine, she'd drown you in it. You must know what risks are worth taking, especially if you wish to have an alliance with me. Things have changed. My father has recently taken an interest in Ironwood. Most of the Royal Navy went up in green flames. It must be rebuilt. He insisted I handle things myself. I'm on my way to meet representatives of Lord Whitehill.
Lord Whitehill?
He's hired a pair of merchant lords to broker for his house. It would seem Lord Whitehill wishes to sell the ironwood right out from beneath your family. I don't know much about the man, but judging by his up-jumped sellswords, negotiating with him won't be pleasant.
You can't trust Lord Whitehill.
I don't intend to. Come with me. These men think I have no choice but to deal with them. Imagine their surprise when I bring a forester to the table. It might be the first fun I've had in months. My lady.
We've been waiting here for an hour.
Andros, be courteous.
Courtesy in a merchant. Like finding gold in your chamber pot. Apologies, my lady.
Who is this? Some girl you've brought for entertainment?
She's a lady, Lord Andros.
Just a handmaiden, my lords.
What does that mean?
Allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Mira Forrester?
Why are you here?
A fair question.
We were told we would be speaking to Lord Tyrion alone.
That's a private matter, my lords.
Foresters have nothing to offer, my lord. If you want ironwood, you'll have to deal with the Whitehills.
Andros? I'm sorry, Lady Mira, but we've already spoken to Lord
you
Tyrion.
You spoke, I listened. Lady Mira has since persuaded me to consider her offer first. Now, if you'll excuse us.
You're going to dismiss
us? You can't do this.
I assure you, I can.
This is a mistake, my lord.
I don't think so.
Lord Whitehill will hear of this. He's not a man to take such matters lightly.
Tell whomever you wish, my lord. It's no concern of mine.
We'll see about that. Lord Tyrion.
Lord Tyrion, do let me know when you've come to a decision. I'd like the opportunity to change your mind. Lady Mira.
Good day, gentlemen. Ah, well, that was fun. Now, as for your offer, what did you have in mind?
My lord?
The Crown's Ironwood. I assume you have a proposition? You had a reason for coming here. I know it wasn't just to entertain me.
Help me stop the Whitehills.
Well, the quickest way to strangle your enemy is with his own purse strings. Say the Crown agrees to buy ironwood solely from you. Lord Whitehill will be left in the cold. If he wishes to sell to the Crown, he'll have to do so through your family. You will have him at your mercy. you'll bring your houses to open war. You do know that's a possibility, don't you?
With you as a partner, that won't happen.
As Master of Coin, I can do many things, but sending an army to the north is not one of them. However, I know your house needs this. I'll consider the arrangement. Of course, you'd have to do something for me in return. Don't worry. The terms will be fair.
What is it you want?
You'll know soon enough. We have an understanding, then.
Thank you, my lord.
This will either be very good for both of us, or very bad for you. For your sake, I hope it's the former.
My lady,